The French Rafale fighter has better specs than the Russian Su-35 jet. According to analysts, the Rafale is clearly superior to the Su-35 jet in terms of engines, combat capabilities, higher weapon carrying capacity, war experience and lethal missile power.
The Rafale fighter jet has been tested on the battlefield. This is certainly different from the Su-35, which has never tasted combat operations. The Rafale jets are equipped with BVRAAM Meteor missiles and SCALP cruise missiles. Consequently, this gives the Rafale unprecedented air-to-air and air-to-surface combat capabilities. The Rafale will likely also be able to fire unique supersonic or subsonic cruise missiles that no other air force in the world has. The Rafale is even more beautiful because it is also equipped with a TV front sector optronics, FSO, sensor that is able to identify targets without the need to activate radar, a feature that is able to operate the Rafale in secret. Operationally, the Rafale is relatively more efficient. For example, for ground attack missions, the Su-35's operating cost per flight hour is more expensive than the Rafale. The Rafale will later fill the role as a medium fighter aircraft with air-to-air and air-to-surface capabilities. It has a slimmer aircraft design. In addition to the wing canards, the Rafale can perform faster flight reversal maneuvers. This feature helps pilots to easily control the Rafale even at high angles of attack. Rafale's AESA radar is more powerful. In out-of-visual range, BVR, combat, the Rafale will have the advantage of seeing and shooting first. It also has the SPECTRA Rafale Electronic Warfare System, EWS, which is immune to enemy radar interference and gives the Rafale exceptional survivability against the latest air and ground threats. SPECTRA's extraordinary ability to manipulate aerial threats is one of the keys to the Rafale's superior situational awareness. According to Dassault engineers, the Rafale's cross-sectional radar is about 0.05 to 0.1 square meters, while the Su-30 MKI puts out an RCS of 10 square meters, unarmed, and 20 square meters, full of weapons. The Sukhoi Su-35 of the Russian Air Force exhibits a number of striking design features. The Su-35 carries a Saturn AL-41F1S engine capable of supporting supercruising, or the ability to maintain supersonic flight without the use of afterburners. The latest Su-35 does not carry canards, small wings in front of the main wing. Like previous variants, however, they are replaced by thrust vector nozzles which contribute to gains in impressive maneuverability in certain dogfighting, or aerial combat, scenarios. Meanwhile, the Su-35S underwent major avionics improvements, including a digital fly-by-wire flight control system, IRBISE phased array radar, and an onboard infrared search and tracking, IRST, system. No less important for its air superiority role, the Su-35 offers an offensive electronic countermeasure, ECM, suite that can interfere with surface-to-air missiles and other similar air-to-air missiles. However, what makes the Su-35 truly superior to competitors in its class like the French Rafale is its payload capacity and versatility, capable of carrying a wide range of weapons spread across 12 hardpoints. The also upgraded R-74 short-range air-to-air missile offers a range of between 40 and 45 kilometers and supports off-bore sight fire. That means Su-35 pilots can target enemy aircraft by viewing them through their helmets within a certain range of view. Moreover, what distinguishes the Su-35 from many similarly positioned air superiority fighters is that it is capable of ground-to-ground bombardment. This is why Su-57 competitors. Initially, the Su-35 was intended as a temporary solution to meet Russia's air superiority needs until the fifth generation Su-57 entered service. However, the Su-35 has apparently proven itself to be a very formidable fighter. The initial performance gap between the upcoming Su-57 and the current Su-35 is expected to be relatively small, especially until the Su-35 begins to be fitted with the latest IZDELIYE-30 engines. Given its consistently impressive performance, cost-effectiveness and versatility of the role, it is unlikely that Moscow will try to aggressively ground the Su-35. In fact, the Su-35 remained in service when dozens of Su-57s were in service.